In this video, we'll be talking about a desktop, a regular desktop PC, and comparing it to a NUC to understand the pros and cons of each solution and when you would use one over the other. So let's start with our traditional desktop computer. So over here, we've got our standard slimline desktop, but you also would be very well familiar with our tower-based desktops and all the different sizes and shapes that a regular desktop would take. So these are our traditional computers. They have standard components and a fairly standard price point. They're very expandable. It's very easy to open them up and swap out components. It's very easy to add components if you need an extra hard drive or an extra graphics card or some sort of adjustment to the PC. Then we have our NUC computers, or next unit of computing computers. These are a new type of form factor that Intel has released quite a few years ago now. They're very small form factor computers, as you can see, very compact, and usually pack the power of a laptop computer. These NUC computers have a very similar performance to your traditional desktops, but obviously come in a much smaller form factor. So they can be used in a wide variety of different applications. So obviously you can use them in a traditional desktop environment. You can hide it underneath your screen or even attach it behind your screen and screw it to the back of your screen to make an all-in-one computer. But they're also really great in other applications. So in a boardroom environment or in a meeting room environment, these are great little devices so that you can hide them away in a cupboard or connect them to the back of the presentation TV in the meeting room and be your video conferencing facility or something similar. NUCs can come in multiple different configurations, just like a normal desktop PC. You can get very cheap NUCs that are great for low-powered applications, all the way up to extremely powerful NUCs that have i7 processors and gigs of RAM and very large solid-state drives that can do basically everything except for high-performance graphical applications. Many clients have use cases where they travel quite a bit, they go to conferences or different types of presentations where having a computer is better than having a laptop, for example, to connect to signage or any dashboarding use cases, where having a very small portable device is preferable than lugging around a big desktop computer. So one of the key downsides of a NUC is that because of its very small form factor, it has limited ports, as you can see. In most cases, this is not a problem. There's more than ample USB ports in most NUC devices, but when there are specialized applications or specialized ports that are needed, certain display ports or certain serial ports, you're gonna run into trouble. Comparing that back to the desktop usually has a multitude of ports and is very expandable to add extra ports if you need them. Another downside of the NUC is that it's very hard to expand. So for example, a NUC would usually come installed with a hard drive. If you wanted to add a second hard drive, it's basically impossible. You could likely swap components, but expandability is very, very difficult. Comparing that back to the desktop, expandability is one of its biggest strengths. If you need to add more memory, if you needed to add another hard drive, if you needed a new or dedicated graphics card, it's very easy to add. When we're looking at price versus performance for each of these devices, you're often going to find that your price versus performance is always higher in the traditional desktop scenario. While you can usually get a NUC that performs at a very high performance, when you're looking at raw performance per dollar, it's usually the desktop that comes out the winner. So how do you work out which device is best for you? It always comes down to determining and being very clear upfront about what is your purpose? What do you need out of this device? So for example, if you're needing a computer to do a lot of graphically intensive applications or have a high performance requirement, then always a desktop will be your best bet. If your requirements are related to using small amount of space, so say for example, a computer in a meeting room, or for example, you have some signage requirements and you have a very limited amount of space to put your computer, then obviously the NUC will be a really great option. The gray area comes in with your standard office worker. Both computers will be able to handle the performance of opening Excel, opening Outlook, browsing the web. As always, if you have any specific requirements or unsure about which device is best for you, you can always get in touch with us or any other IT professional to help you decide on which device is best for you.